Salaam alaikum. Good morning, how are you today? Very good, very good. All right, I had a chance to look at your writings over the past week, and I've noticed some things that we need actually to pay attention to whenever you're writing. These are most of some things that we actually discussed in a class, so it is important today to give you feedback on your writing, and also to give you some ideas and focus, highlight some of the problems that I often see whenever you are writing your paragraphs. So today we're going to just zoom in at some examples of your writings and try to address some of these problems. Hopefully that after that, that you will be able to correct and pay attention to any kinds of problems that you might see in your writings. All right, so let's see, let's look at this first example of your of one of your writings, and let's quickly read it and see what sort of problems can you see in this paragraph. All right, so things like we talked about already, things like paragraph form, the layout of the paragraph, subject verb agreement, comma splice, run on sentence structure, and so on. What I'd like you to do now is to read quickly this paragraph and tell me what sort of problems do you see in this paragraph. All right. Sort of problems, let's discuss this example and try to identify the kinds of problems that you see in this example, in this paragraph. Any ideas? What sort of problems do you see here in this paragraph? Yes, please.
The margin isn't regular.
The margins are not
regular.
Very good note. Idea. Yes, please. What else?
Punctuation
problems, alright? Alright, let's discuss the format of paragraph. Is this the correct format, paragraph format? Is this the correct form?
No.
Of course not. We said that any paragraph, you don't leave lines empty, alright? So you write basically on every line, and you don't have this kind of layout, this kind of form. So you finish the sentence here, alright? Right here, first. Don't leave the half of the line blank and start a new line. Do not start a new line like this. So it is should be like here, because we're talking about a paragraph form, not an essay. Alright? So we're starting with the paragraph form. Alright. So I finished here. The writing is second is to write here. And the same thing, right here. So don't leave any spaces. Alright, unless you come to the end of the paragraph of the line, then you start a new line like naturally. But this way is not the correct way. You have always to write in every line. So the first thing of our checklist is always check your paragraph form. Alright, so the first thing, paragraph form. Or paragraph format. Alright? Alright. Anything else? Alright, anything else? Yes, please.
The sentence is
there is some repetition.
Yes.
in this paragraph. Very nice idea. Let's look at the topic sentence. Is there a topic sentence? Alright, just read the first sentence. Is there a clear topic sentence?
Yes.
University differ from high school, such as number of lectures, time of lectures, and exams. I agree, there is a clear topic sentence, but it means, yes, because here, and here, you're talking about number of lectures, time of lectures, and exams, but we needed to rewrite it in a better way, okay? Are there clear supporting sentences? Just go over them. Are they clear supporting sentences? I think they are okay, but we need some more development.
Yes.
We need some more development. We'll see later on a very clear example of what a paragraph on this topic should look like. Is there a conclusion?
Yes,
there is a conclusion. Okay, but it needs some fine-tuning, some tweaking, so that we are able to present a clear idea and a clear conclusion. All right? So in this paragraph, yes, the structure is clear. We have a topic sentence, we have supporting sentences, but they need some development. And then we have a concluding sentence. But let's look at the grammar, which is very important at this stage. Let's look at the first sentence. Is there a problem with the grammar here?
Yes.
University differ from high school, such as the number of lectures, time of lectures, and exams.
Differs.
Alright, so there is a problem here. Always with that? Always check your subject verb agreement. Okay? University differs. This is something called subject verb agreement. Alright? So at this stage you should be able to address, to avoid these making these kinds of problems. Always make sure that the subject agrees with the verb or vice versa. The verb agrees with the subject. University differs. Universities differ from school. So the first, second thing that you need to look at is subject verb agreement. Make sure that you avoid making any kinds of mistakes that relate to the grammatical point of subject verb agreement. We are still in the first sentence. What problems do you see in this first sentence? Let's look at punctuation. Is there a correct punctuation here in the sentence?
No, such as.
Punctuation.
High school.
Do we have to capitalize high school?
No.
There is no need for capital letter here. All right? Can you see this? I would like to just to sensitize your awareness, to make sure that you have like these forensic eyes, you know, a forensic look at your writing. Just make sure that there is no need for a capital letter here for high school. So the third thing that we need to look at is capitalization. Just make sure that you capitalize where necessary, according to the things, to the rules that we talked about. Don't capitalize randomly, in a random way. Just make sure that you know the rules of capitalization and apply them correctly. Alright, so we don't need to capitalize high school. Alright? Alright, such as, do you know that we used a comma before, such as the number of lectures, times of lectures, and exam. Alright? Let's look at the second sentence. And do you have any problems here? Look at punctuation and capitalization. Again, what do you notice? What do you notice in the punctuation and the capitalization? All right. Yes, please.
The comma, it comes
before. Before, but very nice. So it is not here. It should be here. I saw this quite often in some of your writings. So when the comma is always before the coordinating conjunctions, not
before.
After it. So it is comma, but comma, so not so comma, and so on.
Yeah.
And the same thing.
Yeah,
what do you notice about all? There is no need for capitalizing all. All right. So first of all, comma. In university, you choose your lectures, but in school, you have 5 or 6 classes. Very nice. Okay? So, make sure that you have this, what we call number agreement. Okay? 5 or 6, it takes a plural noun, not singular. Now, 1 problem, 5 problems. Alright? So, the fourth Number four is the number agreement. Alright, so make sure that the number agrees with the noun. For example, two problems, two people, one child, two children, 10 children, and so on. Alright? Let's see the third one. Second, in university you can choose your lecture times. You have some in the morning and some lectures in the afternoon. There is a very clear problem that we talked about last time in the last lecture. Is a very clear. Remember, we talked about run-on and comma splice. Is that correct? Where is that? What is the problem here? Yes, Iman.
It's
run-on
sentences.
It's a comma splice sentence because of the comma here. There is no. It's only one comma between two sentences, and this is not correct. All right. How can we fix it? Oh, we can just simply say correspond. All right. Okay. So we have two ways. Either we add comma so or full stop and start the new sentence. So this idea, this is a comma splice. Alright, so we have to avoid comma splices and run on. So number five, the fifth point that we need to look at to address is avoid run on and comma splice. Okay, and comma splice sentences. All right. So these are very important things that we need to address and need to pay attention to whenever we write. Finally, in university, you have to study to get a high marks, but because of the hard exams, but in school isn't much difficult than university exams. Do you notice any problems here? Clear. There are at least two problems with punctuation and with number agreement. What are they? Yes, please.
To get high marks.
To get a high marks. Is that correct?
No.
Of course not. To get high marks. So there is no need for the A here because it's a plural noun. Okay? So here we're looking at number four. Number agreement. Okay? Anything else?
University.
Should be capital or small letter?
Small letter.
Okay? Alright, school. But in school, small letter or capital letter?
Small letter.
Alright. Finally, to sum up, university more different than school. To sum up? Yes. Don't need a full stop. University small letter is the verb is missing. Okay, so we're talking about again subject verb agreement. You make sure that every subject has a verb and it agrees with it. Alright, so these are 5 points, and let's add something like comma rules. Make sure that you apply the comma rules where necessary. I'd like you to write these 6 things later on, so that you always have this checklist in front of you, before you, whenever you are right. Make sure that you have a clear paragraph form. Second thing, you have
subject-verb
agreement. Make sure that every subject agrees with every verb, with its verb. Capitalize where necessary.
Number
agreement. Avoid run-on and comma splice. And finally, make sure that you know when to use a comma and when not to use a comma. Is that clear? Alright. Very quickly, let's look at this second example of your paragraph, or of some of your classmates' paragraphs. And very quickly, let's look at the problems here. What do you notice first thing? The format is not the correct format. We shouldn't leave spaces here. And so on. Make sure that you write on every, don't skip lines. Just write like as in one block, all right? Anything else? It is very important to say in this subject that difference between high school and university are what? Is there a clear topic sentence? Of course not. There is no need for this sentence. Is that correct? There is no need to write it. It's just repetitive and unnecessary. And this is like an announcement, very nice. It's like an announcement, all right? And the same thing is this a sentence. The difference between high school and university a lot. No, it's more of a title. There is no verb. There is no subject verb relationship or subject verb agreement. How can we write it? We could say there are three differences. There are a lot of differences between high school and university. Or we can say university and high school differ in many ways. Differ in three important ways and so on. Okay? Alright. So, because of time, let's look at this modern paragraph. And I'd like you just to pay attention to how we presented the information, how we wrote the paragraph in a very nice and a very effective way. Alright? First thing we notice that it has the proper format. Alright? We wrote basically on every line. I'm not going to let you read it very, because it's quite big. But just you notice the university is different from high school in three important ways. Very clear topic sentence. The controlling idea is right there. The differences or three differences between high school and university. First, the first point or the first difference. The university is much bigger than the high school in the student numbers and the size and location of
buildings.
This is the first difference. But it's not enough just to write one difference. We have to provide examples. We have to discuss it because it is not enough to make the idea clear. So we say, for example, there are 20 or over 20,000 students in the university and many big buildings, blah, 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 as you can see. So now the idea is now clear, okay? Then we look at the second difference. Second, the university study system largely differs from that of the high school. To illustrate, all right? University students take many related courses. In the same major, go to different lecture rooms and take different kinds of assessments, blah, 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 blah. Then, finally, students take much responsibility for their learning than they do at high school. And then we have an example to clarify the idea. And finally, in conclusion, university life is very different, so students must really do their best to succeed. So what we see in this example, a very clear, nicely written paragraph on this topic. Clear topic sentence, very clear development of ideas, and then we have a conclusion. The format is very appropriate, and then we don't have problems in the grammar, in the capitalization, in the comma use, and so on. Is this clear?
Yes.
All right. Now, let's just look at these, some of your writings, and try to identify the problems in these things, in these following sentences. I'll give you some time just to go over these sentences and identify the problems in them. Yes, please.
Thank you.
All right. What do you notice about the first sentence? What problem do you see in this first sentence? Yes, please.
And the first, it's not good to say that I'm gonna mention so and so.
Okay, so avoid making announcement. There is no need for announcement. There is also another problem. We talked about it. We just talked about it, which is okay. There we have a lot of difference or a lot of differences. A lot of differences. So we're looking at number four.
Yes.
Number agreement. Okay. All right. Let's see the second one. First, in a high school, we wear formal uniform. Full stop. But in the university, we wear what we want. Yes, please. Okay, so before that, there has to be
comma.
A comma. All right.
Yes.
In high school, we wear formal uniform, comma, but. So here we're looking at comma rules. All right, that is always, yes, number three.
Yes.
Number three. Yes, please.
Second, in university, we can depend on ourselves.
Okay, so ourselves, there is no ourselves. Is that right? Yes. So our. On ourselves. Ourselves. Is that correct?
Yes.
Alright, on ourselves. Without ourselves. Okay? Also, second, what do you want to see here? Is that spelling correctly? Is that spelled correctly? No, of course not. So it's not. Okay. So it's number seven, spelling. Avoid making spelling mistakes. Okay. And university we can depend. Again, spelling mistake. We can depend on ourselves. Alright? So make sure that you don't make too obvious spelling mistakes. Okay? Don't make spelling mistakes all the time. Number four. Second, we can watching a foreign movie or you can listen to another person who talks language. Alright, there is a clear problem here. Is
second, we can watch.
Alright, is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, we can watch, not watching. So we're talking about subject verb agreement and the correct verb. Okay, the correct form of the verb. We can watch, we can go, we can travel, but not we can traveling. Okay, so number five. Number five. Yes, please.
Studying in university is what?
Alright, studying in university is what it is?
Is.
Because this is a subject and this is another subject, we cannot use two subjects like this. So studying in university is more difficult and complicated. Complicated. A spelling mistake. Is that correct? Yes, please.
Finally,
all right, these are just very nice, but these are just examples from different writings,
yes.
Examples from different paragraphs. Okay, so studying in university, small letter,
yes.
Small letter, all right, is more difficult and complicated. So avoid making mistakes in grammar and in spelling. I have some more examples here to look at.
Thank you.
Alright? Alright, just a moment, this is a checklist. I'm trying to apply it to the problems that we see here in these sentences. Okay, let's look at number six. Yes, please.
There are some negative.
Alright, what do we see here?
There are subject verb.
There are some negative effects of employment on society. What do we have to do here? Full stop. Is that correct? We're starting a new sentence. So this is like a run on. So, is that correct? Run on sentence. There is no punctuation between them. First of all, unemployment. First of all, unemployment has to be
small.
There's no need for it to be a capital letter. Unemployment causes destroying. Causes subject verb. Agreement. Unemployment causes destroying country economic. How can we say destroying country economic? Causes the destruction of a country's economy. Okay. All right. Causes destroying. We can say a country's economy. Alright? Or the economy of causes the destruction of a country's economy. Alright? So the important thing is that capital letter. Don't use capital letter unless necessary, and also subject verb agreement, and equally important, avoid making run-on sentences. Alright, let's see the second example. Yes, please. Over there. Alright. The unemployment causes many problems. Many problems on the society. On the stock. Again, it's another example of a run-on sentence. Alright, the employment, what do you see here? Small letter. Alright, so, and there's no need for that because it's sort of a generic noun, definite. So we don't need unemployment causes many problems on the society. Full stop. A semicolon. For example, unemployment again. Small letter leads people to do illegal activities. Now it's better a better written sentence. Let's see number eight. First, in university, you can choose the subject that I can study it and feel comfortable with it. In contrast, in high school, we committed to study the subjects that choose by the school. Well, there are quite a few number of mistakes. Okay. Yes, please.
First, N.
N has to be
small
letter. All right.
You can choose the subject that I can.
Okay, so you and I, there's no agreement in pronouns. You can study the subject that
you can.
There's no need for that. We'll talk about it later on, inshallah, next week, about pronoun agreement. Okay, this is an important topic that we'll talk about. That you can choose the subject that you can study, there's no need, and feel comfortable with the full stop.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
In contrast,
comma.
In high school, we are committed to study the subjects that those subjects that are chosen by the school. All right. Now the grammar is correct using the correct form of the passive structure.
Yes.
All right. Let's see number nine.
Yes.
To conclusion, yes, please.
Conclude.
All right. Very nice. So to conclusion, there is no like. There is nothing like called to conclusion. It's either in conclusion or to conclude. So to conclude. Unemployment effects negative
affects.
Affects. Very nice. So it is a verb. In the spelling should be correct. Affects negative.
Spelling mistakes.
Negative.
Yes.
On the society
spelling
and causes
mistakes.
A lot of problems. Alright, so causes a lot of
problems
in society. And also society IE. So here we're talking about spelling mistake. Don't make obvious spelling mistakes. And finally, in conclude, university rules is more flexible than school rules. And yes, please.
In
conclusion,
University
rules is
R.
Member agreements are more flexible. Okay, very good. Then school rules. Alright, so what we see here in these examples are some problems that we can identify, and we should be aware of them next time we write. These include paragraph form. Okay, make sure that the paragraph is properly formatted. Okay, the second thing is avoid making subject-verb agreement problems related to subject-verb agreements. The third thing is capitalize where necessary. As we saw in this example, unemployment, the U here is a small letter, not a capital letter. And
number
agreement. A lot of differences, not a lot of difference. Okay? And avoid making run-on and comma splice sentences. And apply the comma rules that we studied correctly. And finally, don't make obvious spelling mistakes. Okay, are these things are clear to you?
Yes.
So inshallah, next time, whenever you write, make sure that you avoid these making these kinds of mistakes. And remember, this is a checklist. We're going to add to this checklist in the times and weeks ahead, inshallah. All right? All right, thank you very much, and inshallah, I'll see you next time.